Dublin follow up their comfortable win over Laois last weekend by making two changes for this latest qualifier match. Shane Durkin comes into the back line in place of Kian O'Callaghan, and at half forward, Dara Plunkett replaces Kian Boland. Limerick also make two changes from the side which triumphed against Westmeath. Seamus Hickey replaces the injured Tom Condon at right cornerback, and there's a start on the 40 for Declan Hannan at the expense of Shawnee Tobin, who's among the subs.
Done, I think, at the level that we'd have all have expected to. So you know, Dublin and Limerick, massive match for both teams and for both managers tonight. You know, their first day out, they both had, you know, reasonable innings. Obviously, Dublin looked like they were going to win the day against Galway the first day and missed that free in the 68th minute with David Tracy, lost the replay in, you know, they were completely whitewashed on the day. And likewise, Limerick, you know, after a great win over Clare, you know, they were completely lacklustre against Tipperary. So it's a real crossroads. You know, they've managed to get through. You know, they jumped the hurdle we expected them to jump last weekend, winning their matches. But again, today, huge amount at stake. And I'm expecting to see a really good battle here today in Turles.
I suppose that's the point, Moss, isn't it? That at this stage, the stakes are so high that they can't but perform on a day like today.
Yeah, there's no room for excuses anymore, Jackie, today. You know, I mean, we look at team selections and all the changes that have been made. I suppose the beauty of both teams, right? I mean, after their losses in the championship campaign, they got relatively easy games the next time out against Laois and Westmeath, and they were expected to win those games and win them comfortably. But they also got the opportunity to make a few changes, bring a few guys into the fray to see could they step up to the plate. And
otherwise, gives it back. And it's Wayne McNamara who was trying that shot before it was blocked down. Kian Lynch then hand-passing it into the centre here. And finally, Paddy O'Brien lets fly and puts it over the bar. Good start for Limerick and for Paddy O'Brien.
Definitely, Paddy O'Brien, I think, restored to what's his best position in number five. Interesting that Kian Lynch is operating at left half forward. Not in.
Said there was an elbow there, an unfair challenge by Kian, by Liam Rushrother. Got 8 points in the league quarter-final loss to Dublin. Today he makes sure out here towards Shane Dowling. Led off back to his centre-half back, who is Gavin O'Mahony. And Gavin O'Mahony plays it to the left this time and misses the opportunity. Kevin Downs, nothing comes of it. Paul Shute tries to get the ball out on as far as Danny Sutcliffe. Sutcliffe has support here from Ryan O'Dwyer. Playing on his home patch, the Tipperary man hits the shot high and puts it over the bar. Very good point by Ryan O'Dwyer, who got a point also here in his championship debut against Limerick for Tipperary back in 2007, and he's made it 2 points to one here.
Yeah, good settling score by Ryan O'Dwyer, badly wanted for Dublin just to get off the mark.
From the puck out, taken quickly and taken short, Shawnee O'Brien has the effort and puts it away.
You need to be bringing forward those guys all the time.
Shane Dowling is one from one so far with his freeze. Now here's the second one from the 65. Low trajectory, straight as a die, however, and straight over the bar. So another fielder, nicely downed here, taken by David Breen in his stride. Strong man, missed a goal opportunity earlier on, and he has missed this one as well. He'll be very, very,
very frustrated.
That's six wide so far. Richie McCarthy. They're ahead still by two. Down towards Kevin Downs, plying on the pressure here, swings around. Oh, that's a lovely score by Kevin Downs. It's good to see him back in the big time. He's only 23 years of age, then a Pearshig player, recovered from injury, tight angle, did really well. 4-1. Ryan. And Ryan's out there, not just to lend his considerable physique, but it's his free-taking style and ability. Virtually flawless, and that's well. Gets it away downfield, all the way in there. Inside towards Eamon Dillon, beaten for that one by Richie McCarthy. He may not have been at his best against Tipperary, but he started well here. Big one down. Taking it up here is Graham Mulcahy. High challenge on him, gets it back and puts it over the bar. Good score by Mulcahy. His first opportunity, really, to delight these Limerick fans who've travelled. Paul Brown, ready to take off again here. Dara Plunkett goes after him, trying to get the stick in there. Brown now needs someone to take it from him. James Ryan is that somebody. But again, the finishing leaving an awful lot to be desired.
Yeah, I suppose. But from Dublin's point of view, if they can stay in touch and if Mark Shute can grab one, stick in the net, that turns the game back in their favour, and that's what they'll be hoping for.
This is dropped into the square this time towards Breen. Comes back out here, a little change of direction on the part of Declan Hannan. Inside Downs, trying to get to it, and again it's gone off a defender. It's going to be another 60.
the way to be doing it, really.
So this time, I think, having done the rehearsal, he should manage to get it spot on, and he manages to drive it right between the two uprights for point number three out of 6 out of 10 for that. Artistic merit. Line ball taken. That's a good one. That's straight over it. It's Declan Hannan. Beautiful sideline cut. This guy got 11 points from the team's last minute of the championship meeting here some years ago. Five of trying to take on Corcoran. Doesn't need to beat him. Hits the shot in here. He's going to drop short. And Gary Maguire once again can restart. Dublin are, as you can see, five behind. They haven't really done very much of the hurling so far. Dara Plunkett beats the attempted block of Paul Brown. And then there is a slip in there. And that slip was by Mark Schute, leaving his man, Seamus Hickey, to get out there. There was a block on it after.
Always, and they target big championship games. They'll be gutted the last day. And, you know, they got Westmeath out of the way, and they'll be anxious to drive on from here.
Right now, it's Liam Rush who's hoping to drive David Breen out of the way, but Breen has it, and Breen scores! He's done it before for them. He's done it here. He's been threatening, and he finally gets a goal after 26 minutes, his sixth ever time to score a goal in the hurling championship. It was a cracker. David Breen cut in, goalkeeper came out.
Just, you know, shrugged off Liam Rush with his strength and drove forward at the goal instead of coming away from the goal, and a great score. We see a good response from Dara Plunkett straight away, but I mean, that's a huge score at this stage of the game.
Well, Dublin need to refocus very, very quickly here, because they're in danger of being out of sight by half-time. The way this match is going at this stage, when you consider that Limerick have also had 9 wides, they've had 8 scores, and they've had that big score from David Breen just moments ago. And they're coming again here now with Declan Hannan, and Hannan floats it over, his second. They're playing really well here, Limerick. They've cast aside any doubt. They're very much a championship team, as Anthony Daly was saying, and they're here to down the colours of Dublin.
Yeah, good finish now, and they'll need him on song to get back into this game.
It looks like he's going to come on for Eamon Dillon as Paul Ryan hits his second free and puts it over the bar. Okay, driving it down. Great catch by Wayne McNamara. Needs to go after it himself, however. Intervening is Paul Ryan, right on the sideline. Ryan speculatively hitting it and putting it over. He's that kind of player. Paul Ryan, capable of anything. His third point in this match, the first to come from open play. Look at the angle. It was wickedly difficult.
Yeah, Paul Ryan special, you could call it.
Be working his socks off so far. Back to Gavin O'Mahony. Again, hitting one. Remember the 8 points he got against Dublin a few years ago here in an All-Ireland.
Is that they can cut it back. So every chance is vital now that Dublin would take it.
But Paul Ryan's got 4 so far. Steering this one beautifully. 4 points for him. Hit away somewhat carelessly to Liam Rush. Taken in here by Dara Plunkett. Change of direction here. It's Dara Plunkett who's going to have to do it himself. Mulcahy goes chasing after him. Eventually leaving it out here as far as Mark Schute, looking for his first score and putting it over the bar. And Dublin have put on a spurt, and now they're back within a few points. They're back within 4.
Yeah, and it was a crucial few minutes.
Opening 35. So we've got another 90 seconds or thereabouts, and a chance now for Paul Ryan as he will go across here to take this resultant free after the foul there by Richie McCarthy to put just a goal.
So, got to try and avoid him as best you can.
And there's no avoiding Paul Ryan. However, he's put that one wide.
Yeah, it's been a lacklustre first half. Maybe conditions have set the tempo there. But at one stage in that first half period, with all the wides, 11 wides for Limerick, I mean, they could be out of sight at this stage, and there would be no way back. Now they find themselves 1-8-7 points, only ahead of 4 points. Dublin have come back into the game. I think Limerick will be happy, but they'll be upset with all the chances that they created and didn't take those opportunities. Tactically, they've probably won the battle as well. They've had an extra man back in defence, mopped up, no room for the Dublin forwards to get inside. And I think the key was they brought young Mulcahy and Cian Lynch out to their half-forward line, where Dublin were expecting them to play inside, and I think he picked his full-back line on that basis. So if they went man-marking, they had to go side afterwards, which left kind of gaping holes. And there you saw the David Breen arriving to pick up and get the goal chances that he got. Because he was picked that forward, he's coming in behind that half-back line and picking up those goal-scoring opportunities.
Yeah, he got a couple of goal-scoring opportunities. He took one of them really well, Liam, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. And, you know, Dublin probably lacked a little.
Little or no breeze around. If there is a breeze, it's blowing from right to left as he's hitting this one across the field. and he's dropping it in and over the bar. It's another one back here as far as Dotsie O'Callaghan. David back to John. Johnny McCaffrey out to Paul Ryan. They're taking a couple of moments to get it spot on. They get it right and they put it over the bar through the intervention of Paul Ryan. Two in a row for him. And Dublin now have gone some 6 points of this match without a Limerick score in reply.
Yeah, for sure, the Limerick management will be working
properly. Comes for Conal Keeney, however, trying to slip the ball back to a support player. That is Ryan O'Dwyer, trying to hold it away there from Shawnee O'Brien. Finally, the ball driven back towards Paul Ryan. It's gone over the bar. It's another one. Yet another score here for Paul Ryan, his seventh in this match. He's threatening to take this game by the scruff of the neck.
A tremendous work in the corner, Ger, by the Dublin forwards. They hounded the Limerick backs, wouldn't let the ball out. Somebody has to take responsibility for Paul Ryan in the Limerick defence, because at the moment he's getting far too much space, and if he gets space, he will punish.
Study and concentration. Light breeze behind him now, if the flags are to be trusted, and he trusts this one.
But was there a strike in action? It's hard to know. There seemed to be. To be fair, and sideline here at the minute, and a double substitution on the way.
That's another one for Paul Ryan. He was hardly going to miss. 27th minute was when they last scored, and Dowley needs to get this, and I think he's got it. He has. About 20 metres out from that Limerick goal, it bounces around in there, and David O'Callaghan is the first to get it. So nimble, small man. Back it goes to Conal Keeney, looking for the next score. Keeney's put it wide, however, and that's seven wides now for Dublin.
Just his first poke, I suppose, but it's not the worst chance ever, I guess.
No, it's not, and it's his first chance back, of course, since the 30 seconds he had here against Clare when he was red carded following his introduction. But he's made a good start here, and he's put that one over the bar, and Limerick lead once again by 110 to 12 points. 47, nearly 48 minutes are gone. A lot of the game to go. Puck out to Shane Durkin of Dublin. Dublin looking to get back immediately now. All the way in there towards Mark. And that one towards Mark Schutte doesn't reach him. It reaches Richie McCarthy instead. What a match he is playing in there, taking on the entire Dublin forward line, it seems. Perhaps he needed to get rid of it, but couldn't do so. Conal Keeney back out here as far as Johnny McCaffrey. Good pressure play by Dublin. They've won the ball back and then turn it over. In went Paul Brown. Then getting some support here from Dan Morrissey. Morrissey hits it in over the head of Paul Schutte. Is it under control? And then tries to steal a march, rather unwisely, and Limerick have loose players inside. Declan Hannan is waiting inside. He was unmarked for a moment here. Shawnee Tobin in the end hits it and fires it over the bar. Two for Shawnee Tobin. He's made an impact since coming on here as a substitute for Shane Dowling. And now Limerick lead by 111 to 12 points. Limerick by two.
Yeah, I guess, Aaron, when you're in that full back line, you never hesitate with a ball like that. Paul Schutte hesitated, and he just should have driven the ball upfield, even out over the line, just to give them a chance to resettle. And Tobin robbed him, and man over all right, Declan Hannan, but probably did the right thing to take the point, to stretch it to two at this stage. How vital is that? You know, we face into the last 19, 20 minutes, a two-point gap again, crucial.
Bad, important, and he realises that importance, and he's got... Still can go forward, they can't catch him, great pace. Laying it off inside here to Mark Schutte. Stopped there initially, but then he gets off again and the referee allows him an advantage. They're almost walking it in. Oh, it's gone over the bar. There was a goal there for the taking. Darragh Plunkett gets his second, one in each half. It's amazing.
Yeah, Jeremy, you're not going to get too many better chances of goals than that. To be fair to him, he created the chance himself by a searing run through the middle, gave off to Mark Schutte, but that's a massive chance of a goal if he could have kept it down. And
it. Trying to play hockey with it almost, trying to get it forward here. In the end, it's Graham Mulcahy stopped. Paddy O'Brien back out here. James Ryan hooked by Sutcliffe. Almost got it back. Dublin do eventually take it back. Johnny McCaffrey slipping it back to Shane Durkin. Now getting some length into this one. Putting a bit of pressure on Shawnee O'Brien over there. Taken down here well. Paul Ryan looks up, sees where it goes and sees where it lands. The usual place. He's having a really good afternoon. Trying to link up with Mark Schutte. Schutte's got very little, but he's got the ball this time. Got it away from his man, Shawnee O'Brien. Inside here, Dotsie! Stop of the goalkeeper's leg, I think. Great stop. Doesn't matter how you stop it, the goalkeeper resourcefully manages to deny Dublin a goal opportunity. Limerick can counter and will do so successfully. Here they come, Mulcahy shooting and putting it over the bar. That's a turnaround of about 4 points. They could have been a goal down. Instead, they've got another one from Mulcahy at the other end, and it's 113 to 14 points.
Yeah, and it's the old famous 4-point swing one, we call it. You know, that the chance of the goal at one end, brilliant save by Quaid, justified the decision to bring him back on after that ankle injury, and they go down the other end, and a crucial point again to shove it out. I mean, how massive is that in the course of the game? Dotsie didn't do too much wrong, and now they've won a free out.
Positioning of that up as far as Donal O'Grady, the team captain, hits it. Gary Maguire looks about. Every attack now is vital. Shane Durkin, Dublin will feel they need to score from this one. It's two against three. Dotsie O'Callaghan buries it. What a comeback! Dublin into the lead by 114 to 113. There were defenders there. They were there in numbers. They should have been able to get to it. Horrible mix-up, and Dotsie, cool as you like, slots it in past Nicky Quaid to make it 114 to 113.
And how often have we seen the great corner forward, you know, predator-like instincts of the Dots, you know, just wait.
Fans have seen the ups and downs of Championship hurling in recent years, living on the nerves.
And a few subs, I think, about to be into the fray. I see David Tracy coming for Dublin. David Reedy certainly coming for Limerick. Cahill King coming as well, so
just. But it's there to be won in the next 4 minutes. Let's see who's going to do it. Kian Boland for Dublin, maybe. Boland firing it. Is it going inside that left hand upright? It is. It's got over the bar. Dublin lead by a point. They're ahead by 115 to 114. What a great ball he won there. Giving it to Paul Ryan, who's got 10, he's got 11. Stunning performance by Paul Ryan. But we're now into the 3 minutes of added time. So Dublin by a point. Here comes Crummie, played down once again here towards Paul Ryan, who's got 11 points. That was in there to Danny Sutcliffe, hit with a fierce shoulder. Johnny McCaffrey trying to do something about it. Out came David Tracy, gives it back here to Paul Ryan. Is this on its way over the bar? It is! He's done it! He's got a 12th Paul Ryan, a stunning performance by the 26-year-old man from Ballyboden St. Enda's. 117 to 115. And Dublin by two, and 2 minutes to go. Only a goal will save Limerick, I think, at this late stage, and it's going to be a free in. Will they try and work a goal, I wonder? The referee has already given a yellow card to Chris Cummy. He's now given him a second. That's a red. So Dublin will finish this match with just 14 players. Well, this is it. Is he going to go for it? He is putting it over the bar. He's got a sixth. Less than 30 seconds to go at this stage. Runs on, stopped, comes back out. Late chance, fumbled by Mulcahy, taken up by Paul Shute. 3 minutes almost played. The referee looks, watches, and he looks at his watch again, and the referee lets the play continue. We've played the 3 minutes. It's now all over. And Dublin beat Limerick by a point. A stunning match, a wonderful game, a great contest. Full credit to both teams. And it finishes here in Semple Stadium in Thurles. Dublin 117, Limerick 116.
Absolutely delighted. Like it's had to come back from, I think we were 7 or 8 points on at one stage in the first half. Led showed fantastic character, really good character to get it back. We got it back to four just on half time, and it gave us huge opportunities and to get momentum in the second half. But again, like, just great credit to the lads. That, you know, there was serious questions asked them today, and they dug deep, and delighted for them.
Yeah, massive disappointed, Ger. Come from a major disappointed dressing room there. We'd hurled reasonably well in the first half. Got the goal at the right time, I felt. And, you know, maybe before half time, Dublin got a few scores and got themselves back in the game. And, I mean, they started the second half really, really well. We got ourselves back, conceded a probably poor enough defensive goal. And just wasn't to be. It was very, very disappointing.
Yeah, Donal O'Grady, the reaction this season, it's great for Dublin and Ger. Yeah, make or break, and great for Jor. I think like he deserves a lot of credit. I think last week, including myself, was critical of some of his moves, including bringing Liam Rush back to centre back. But when you look at the year where it stands now, they're after beating Limerick and Thurles, which is no mean achievement. They're in the quarter final of the All Ireland. They retained their Division 1A status, and he's brought in a lot of young players. And like any other manager, it'll probably take him time to settle down. Anthony Daly was a real success with the Dubs, but you look at his first couple of years, 2009, he was knocked out by Limerick. 2010, took a desperate beating off of Kilkenny and was subsequently knocked out by Antrim. So it'll take time.
All right, well, let's go through the game, Eddie. Now, Limerick had a fantastic start, but then it seemed to slip away from him a bit, didn't it?
Yeah, to be fair to him, Limerick started quite well, Des, but as we'll see from it, they just fizzled out of the match a little bit then. But they went at Liam Rush was playing centre-back, he has gone back there, and I thought he brought a little bit of stability. OK, he was caught for the goal, but you can see here, David Breen pulls him off to the right, takes him off out to one side of the pitch, and Limerick go down the far side. Declan Hannan here, who, to be fair, was well marshalled by Paul Shute all night, just times his run, breaks in nicely, and he comes across and picks off a good point. I mean, that's where Liam Rush would normally have been coming to meet you, maybe Johnny McCaffrey working off his shoulder. And that was how they probably unhinged Dublin for a little while. But, you know, we'll see from it. You know, Limerick or Dublin went man to man, but here was where, you know, Limerick were in commands, they weren't clinical. There's a handy point for the taking there off David Breen's left hand. Instead, he puts himself under more pressure, going back into contact. He gets forced out by Barrett. Chris Cummey then comes out and finishes the job by putting pressure on Kevin Downes, who goes for the kind of really ambitious score. He got one like that and he went for a few more, which weren't on. Dublin cleared their lines. And then we have another long ball in. Kevin Downes takes on his man. And for me here, look, again, there's a handy point for the taking there. It's very hard to finish that because he's off balance. He bounces it very hard from a long way out. Mm. And I just thought that when the match was there for Limerick to really deliver the knockout blow, they went 1-7 to 2 points up about maybe 20 minutes, 25 minutes into that match.
And it could have been more.
They had a lot of bad wides. Now, to be fair, I think it was down to Dublin put a lot of pressure on them, but they had 11 wides in the first half. So you even take 50% of them, they would have had Dublin out of sight. But to be fair to Dublin, they roared back into the match, and this was, I suppose, what typified it really, the contrast between both teams. Okay, Limerick worked the ball out. Look, you can see Dublin, two-man full forward line for Limerick, but they're all man-to-man and they are tight on their men, which they were all night long, unlike Limerick. The two O'Briens work it out between the two of them here. Now, what you're looking for here maybe is a forward showing low here. You look at all the space you have, or else work a 1-2 with, you know, and walk it out of defence. Yeah. Instead, they go along. Rush just floats across, picks up the ball and gives it to Darragh Plunkett, who, for me, last night was sensational. I'd love to have had a GPS on this man to see the ground he covered. He's willing to take a hit, takes a good rattle there, throws it out to Mark Shute and pops it over the bar. And that ultimately was the difference between Dublin last night. And I would have felt the scoreline maybe flattered Limerick somewhat. Now, I know the Limerick crowd would have felt maybe they didn't get freeze that... They may have got on other occasions, but I ultimately thought they were probably a little bit the authors of their own downfall a little bit. I mean, you take those wides in the first half, the wides in the second half, but I would be taken from Dublin as well if I did, because they were on the ropes, they were nearly gone, and they worked their way back into that match.
Now, Paul Ryan was one of the stars, he was named man of the match, and he and David Tracy, there's a few of them battling there to get into that team, but he got his chance and really took it, didn't he?
Yeah, that's the thing. David Tracy hit the freeze against Dublin, or Galway the first day, was impeccable. This guy made an appearance against Galway, was brought on in the replay, got taken off in the replay as well, and I've no doubt he had a little jaw on him after that. But last night, he was asked to do a job and he done it with aplomb. He hit six frees, he got six from play. We've seen him there, you know, one from one side of the pitch. This is another one. But what I liked about Dublin was they were willing to work, they were patient with it, and they worked hard. If they lost the ball, a little bit of a hospital pass to Danny Sutcliffe, I won't be thanking him for that. But to be fair, Ryan Dwyer gets in, works again, and David Tracy just spots Paul outside him, one little shimmy and it's over the bar. But an interesting thing, Des, just going back even to the first half, Limerick went 1-7 to 2 points up. Dublin came back and outscored them 10 points to 1 Wow. 10 minutes into the second half. So that put them in front, and that to me probably was the real story of the match. And I thought it was probably a true reflection of that Dublin were that bit better than them.
All right, so it's the Dubs and Waterford now. All right, well, let's go to the second game from Thurles last night, the eagerly awaited clash of Clare and Cork. Could they recreate the excitement and drama of the All-Ireland final from 2013? Let's find out as we join Marty.
This is the Clare team that will start with Patrick Kelly between the posts, defended by quality players like David McInerney, Shane Amori in the corners, with Keane Dillon at number three. Pat O'Connor and Colin Ryan are selected in midfield, but it's the full forward line that will pose the greatest threat. Derek Honan, Shane O'Donnell and Conor McGrath. Cork looks strong down the middle with Patrick Cronin and Seamus Harnedy named in key positions in the Rebels' attack. Daniel Carney and Yall's Bill Cooper are in the middle of the field, while further back, Stephen McDonnell and Mark Ellis play full and centre-back, respectively. It's the repeat of the 2013 All-Ireland Senior Hurling Final. It went to a replay. And certainly if this goes to extra time, they'll be switching on the lights in Simple Stadium, Thurles. Cork playing from left to right. Here comes the first chance. It's Seamus Harnedy from way out the field, and that's straight between the posts. What a start. After 18 seconds of play, Cork are one up. It's the man that's given Cork numerous nightmares over the last number of years. It's Shane O'Donnell. Magnificent in the All-Ireland final with a hat-trick of goals. He levels the match. Good score by the year-old man from the town of Ennis.